The test being conducted on this loading dock at the Fort Interdisciplinary Research Center at North Carolina A&T may be part of the solution to North Carolina's and the nation's coal ash problem. That propane-fueled flame burns at about 2,000 degrees, but even after 10 minutes of direct flame, sensors on the back of the block record the temperature as climbing to just over 100 degrees. The fire and heat-resistant material is called echo core, and, oh yes, it's made of coal ash.
Well, I think this is a miracle stuff. when we first started working on it for the Navy, the main objective was the fire material. But we found out, wow, this stuff is strong. It resists water, seawater, and regular water. And it's got a high strength. Like, this has got a compressive strength of 4,000 PSI, which means you could put a car, stand up a car on a square inch of it, if you could. And it's that strong, which is, to me, is, you know, amazing material.
That's right, coal ash. It is the same material that poured out of a storage pond at a Duke Energy power plant and into the Dan River in February. Coal-fired power plants produce two forms of ash. There's heavy bottom ash, which stays in the furnace, and lighter fly ash, which is a refined component of coal ash and is captured in the plant's smokestacks. The two types of ash are dumped into storage ponds at power plants across North Carolina and the nation.
See, the echo core is actually, it is made up of two. One is the fly ash, which is a very lightweight, hollow ceramic bubbles. And then it actually binder is a high char binder.
Echo core is almost 95% fly ash that is mixed with a liquid polymer resin, or a binder. The paste is then poured into a mold, where it is hot pressed into the desired shape.
The grade of fly ash that we use is little hollow spheres. And these are range in size from 100 to 300 microns. And we're interested in the hollow spheres because we're interested in thermal insulation and lightweight. If it were solid, it wouldn't do the things that we want it to do. The little micro amounts of trapped air becomes extremely important in thermal insulation and fire resistance. We want to coat each one of those little bubbles with the thinnest possible layer of polymer so that when they get together, the only place that the polymer is where the bubbles touch. And then the polymer bonds the bubbles together. And that's where we are. And that's what makes this material good, because we've trapped as much air in it as possible. The material molds really easy because it's like pushing ball bearings together.
Ironically, the engineers decided to experiment with using fly ash as a building material as they were driving past a power plant on the way back from a meeting with the Navy, which was looking for a new material for its ships.
In that process, actually, I struck the idea about fly ash because fly ash contains silica. It's primary ceramic. And they are all hollow bubbles. So that could be a choice.
Fly ash is almost immune to fire because of the intense heat of power production. Researchers boosted the fire resistance even more, up to Navy standards, by heating echo core in an oven. The engineers have spent almost a decade working on the Navy project and perfecting the properties of echo core. The resulting material is useful as the interior part of a wall or ship's hull. But after testing echo core in every way imaginable, its creators believe the uses for echo core are almost limitless.
And this material stands out, is superior. So it just has a fantastic combination of properties.
Trouble is, only a small amount of echo core can be produced in a lab. The team is looking for a manufacturing expert who can figure out how to produce it commercially on a large scale.
Basically, we look at some of the innovative research that's going on campus. We protect it, and then we go out and market the technology to try and find potential companies that can license the technology and bring it to market.
The engineers admit what they call their miracle material won't produce a miracle and solve the coal ash problem, but they believe it will help.
There's a big market out there somewhere for this type of material.